Hi, I'm Gary from organicweb.com.au and I'm a Mailchimp Pro partner. I get asked very often, probably a few times a week even, by people how they can amend an attachment they've added to a Mailchimp email campaign. So what's happened is they've sent a file out via email in Mailchimp and then they've gone, oops, I need to change something. Maybe the spelling's wrong, they need to change an image or something like that. You cannot change the original file if you store it in the Mailchimp Content Studio. So what I'm going to show you is how we can add a file, whether that's a PDF file, an Excel file, a document, whatever it is, how we can add it so that we can actually amend that file, and when people click the original link in the email you sent them, it still works. Let's go across to Mailchimp. You'll notice I'm in Mailchimp. So what we're wanting to do here, I'm just going to go edit design and you'll see that I'm in the new Mailchimp email builder. So what we're wanting to do is we're going to send an email, let's say, to people, and we're going to include a button where they can click, and it could just be a, you know, a normal hyperlink as it were. On this button, what we'll do is we'll create a link where they can view that file, but we'll make sure that we can edit that file. There's actually a little bit of a trick here, but I'll get onto that in a second. What we need to do again is we don't use the Mailchimp Content Studio, because then we wouldn't be able to amend the file and keep the original URL. Because once we've sent the email, we can't change the URL for the file. So what I'm going to show you is how we can do this in Dropbox using a URL shortener. Whether you use OneDrive, whether you use Google Drive, box.com, whatever, to store your files, you can use this way. So what we're going to do is we're going to add a URL shortener link to this button which directs to our file. So let's go through this process. What we would do is we would I'm going to use Dropbox as I said as an example. Upload your file to Dropbox that you want to share. So let's say, and it could be a PDF file again, it could be any sort of file you can store in Dropbox. So let's say this is the file that we want to share. What we do is we just share it. So I'll just get the URL from Dropbox in this case. So I've copied that to my clipboard. I need to use, and it'll become evident why in a second, I need to use a URL shortener. In this case, I'm using tiny.cc. The reason I'm using it is because we can amend the URL. It'll make sense in a second. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to create, for that file in Dropbox, I'm going to create a short URL using tiny.cc. So in this case, I'm just going to click shorten URLs, and I'll just paste in the Dropbox URL, the URL that Dropbox gave me for my file. I'll just type something here. We can shorten it. I'll just click shorten it. Wait for that to load up. Okay, so now at any time when someone goes to that URL, they'll be going to my file in Dropbox. So they'll be redirected from there to Dropbox. So now we want to add this to Mailchimp. So let me just do that in the button. I'm just going to click on the button, add the URL for tiny.cc, as you can see. So I'm not adding the Dropbox. So what I'm doing is tiny.cc gives me a URL that redirects to my file in Dropbox. I'm adding that URL here. Sorry, just bear with me. And let's just change, just because we can. Let's just go click. Yeah, you can put any, obviously any text, you can change the color of the button and so on. So what happens here, the person receives the email, they click that button, they actually sent to tiny.cc, which instantly redirects them to Dropbox, so they don't even realize they're going through tiny.cc. Let's say we want to make a change to this. Okay, so we send that email out, right? But let's say we now want to make a change to that file. Well, the first thing to say is that because I'm using, in this case, Dropbox, or I can edit this file directly because it's a doc file, and certain types of files you can edit directly without changing the URL. But let's say you were using a PDF file. In Dropbox, in this case, I can't edit the PDF file. So what I would need to do is add a new PDF file. So all I do is I go off and I add my new PDF file to Dropbox. I then get the URL for that file, go to TinyCC, and I'll just close out of there, sorry. And what I'm wanting to do is I actually just want to change the short, sorry, not the short URL, the long URL. In other words, the place that the short URL points to. Because what's happening at the moment again is when you click that button in Mailchimp, it's taking you to this URL. TinyCC then says, okay, so for that URL, redirect people to there. But because we've added that new PDF file, all we're going to do is we're going to change this URL. So people will click on our original email, come to this URL instantly, TinyCC will redirect them to Dropbox. So it's a bit of a workaround where for PDF file, we can't edit it, let's say, in Dropbox. But what we can do is we can keep the original URL that Mailchimp points to by using a URL shortener. I hope it all makes sense. So what we could do in this case, in TinyCC anyway, we would click Manage URLs. Then we can quite simply click the little Edit Link button. And into here, I would just change the original destination to the new destination. In other words, that new file that I've uploaded. And you would keep the short hash. In other words, keep that original URL for tiny.cc because that's where our email is pointing to, and save changes. And that's how simple it is. So, just to summarize again, what we need to do is when we send an email from Mailchimp, we cannot change the URL for a button, for example, in a sent email. So what we're doing is we're using a URL shortener because then we can change the URL in the URL shortener. So we keep the URL on our button the same that points to a URL shortener, in this case tiny.cc, and there are many others. And then what we can do in TinyCC is just keep changing the URL there, that so we can add other documents to Dropbox, we can change it and so on. And we just keep changing it in TinyCC. Therefore, our email URL needs just stays the same, that's how we create in our emails. That's how we can edit documents, as it were, sort of a pseudo edit documents. If you found this useful, please like this video, subscribe to my channel, leave any comments. Thanks for joining me. I'm Gary.